Have I? Quite possibly, maybe, maybe not. Have I made it? Okay, let's check. A laptop over here. Give me just uno moments. I don't know. Give me a moment. Okay, we'll see. Oh my god, I look so beautiful. Thank you. I'm welcome. Thank you. Great. Okay. Well, hello everyone, and thank you for tuning in. My name's Sebastian, and welcome to the roguelike text-based RPG series. Now again, like the last time I streamed, the entire stream, this stream, will be exported directly, so you'll have a whatever amount of time video, and then I will also be splitting it into half-hour videos so you can more easily, you know, watch it. I don't know. For some people, half an hour seems like a perfect time for a video. And for other people, they like the long sessions. So there's some for everyone. And I think we should just like get started here. Right. Let's see if the stream is set up properly. Yeah, it seems so. It seems that way. Okay. Well, if you're new to the streams and on YouTube, then remember to go follow the streams so you can get a little notification whenever Twitch fucking feels like it. It helps me out, and it lets me know that you appreciate the videos that I've been doing lately. And it's a lot more fun, this, I think. It's a lot more fun to sit down and actually, you know, do a proper long video, because it's a fucking stream, mate. You can't just, you know, just fuck about on a stream, can you? No, you can't. It's not how it works. Okay, great. Excuse me. I just had a massive bowl of nachos and I'm just burping like a fat guy on a diet. So, I don't know if that's how it works. If you're obese, I'm sorry. God, what a start. Okay. If you don't know what Rogue is, Rogue is this very, very old game from when everything used to be text-based. It's a sneaking-based game. It's where the term roguelike comes from, which has been thrown around quite a lot lately. And it's practically a game about a lot of rooms being... actually, it's a randomly generated world. Okay, so you're faced with the console, which will be the entire game screen. And in there, you'll be thrown into a room to begin with, yeah? A little room, and then your and whatever symbol, then, you know, there'll be symbols in that, in the room, and then it will generate a random number from where to start your it will then generate kind of a passage for you to walk, and on that you will then be led to another room, which will then generate another room or another path, and then another room at some point. And that is what we'll be making. And there will also be bonuses, there'll be points, there'll be health, there'll be every kind of pickup that you'd want. And then there would obviously be... welcome to the stream. Then there would obviously be like a staircase set for you to go to the next level. And then the entire random generating thing would literally just repeat again. And obviously it will save your health, it will save your points, and whatever else we put in there. But mobs will be in there, and again, this will be dice rolled, so if you don't want to sneak by a mob, and you want to rather face it and battle it out, it will be randomly generated whether you actually hit it, or it hits you, or you miss, or it misses, or whatever. So, that's what we'll be doing today, and knowing me, this is going to be quite a messy piece of software, but hello and welcome to the stream. Just everybody tuning in, it's great. So knowing me, it's going to be quite messy, but I think again, to the guys from last stream, I'm sorry, still haven't read up on classes and methods, so we'll be doing it in a way that everyone can follow as well as me. So I think we should just get started. Right, okay, so should we have... I think we should. Okay, so let's start out with the strings and ints. So we'll be having the ints and then the... Damn. The strings. Oh, also, I'm considering, which I think would be very nice for these videos, a new keyboard. Because this has like a weird sound, doesn't it? It's like a dome. It's a weird, shitty keyboard. It's a Logitech G11, which is pretty fucking old. Just considering like a mechanical keyboard, I think that would be cool. But we are going to be creating string, and we'll have like a... Let's have one called draw character, and in here we'll literally just store what the character will look like in the game, and for our use he'll be an X. Okay, and then we'll have one, an int called char health. Yep, and it will be set to a default value of, oh, I don't even fucking know. Let's set it to 100. That's always, you know, easy to deal with. But this will be the current, and we can literally just copy and paste that and say instead of current, it'll be full. Okay, and then should we have some like an int called score? I don't know if there was a... Oh shit, sorry, it shouldn't be a word in here. My bad. I don't know if there was a scoring system in the original. Might be. I mean, it would be good to have in the game, so you can literally just, you know, play it and measure points versus how many your friends have and like how far they've gone. I don't know. I think it would be cool. So we should have like a score, well, set to 0, obviously, because we have none. And we have the character set. We will also need a string array, but this array will literally draw everything that will be on screen. And for the life of me, I don't remember how long or how wide the console interface is. I think it's like 240 by 80. I mean, it would be good. So we'll be creating a string. It'll be a two-dimensional because we'll have both x and y axis, and we'll call it draw game. Let's call it interface. All right, so we'll have a draw game interface, which will literally just draw the entire map. I think it's better to call it game map. Okay, and it will be a new string array of two dimensions, which will be 239 by 79. Yeah, because we're counting from 0, where 0 is also a good or a valid number or a valid spot to put something in. So, with all that said, I think we should just like do this and say program. And in here, we will start the software. And what we'll start out by doing is, let's just, it will have to generate two different numbers. So let's do that, and it will have to be so what we'll need to do to begin with is draw the starting room, the room that you will be you will spawn into, and that room it'll have to be obviously within the game interface. Actually, instead of 80, want to set it to 77. That will give us 78 valid spots to put the thing into, so we can draw the, you know, the health and the score and whatever below that. Okay, so how are we going to do this? I've got no clue. Okay, so we will need a random number generated, but I think it will have to be in here, so we'll have to do like a do and oh shite, and within this we'll do a while, and we'll have like a cool game over. So as long as game is not over, which it hopefully, I mean, you know, it's all about keeping the score going, so hopefully you won't reach that forever and ever and no, okay. Take a swing. I was thinking of making some coffee at one point. I think that would be good. You know, when we've been streaming for a while, just grab a nice old pot of coffee and, you know, get down to biz. Okay, so in the do while, we'll have a random. So I think it's like random, and we will call it... what will this actually be? It'll be like spawn point generator. Actually, you know what would be nice is if we could, I know I'm, you know, sidetracking a bit. How do we do this? How do I do this? Give me a minute. This will be good. What I wanna do, properties, no, that's not it. What does I go for this? Where does I go for this? See, what I wanted to do was increase the font size. I mean, obviously there should be a way to do this, but fuck me if I can find it. Let's see. Okay. No tools. Oh yeah, I might be on the tools. Right. Okay, let's ignore that. Fonts and colors, there we go. And increase the font size to at least a 12. There you go. Oh shit, that's good. So it'll be equal to a new random within... You'll create a new random... How do you even do this? I forget. Is it like you do this from 0 to... And it can't be 240 because then it will draw the... Actually, it might be 240. Okay, let's set it to 230. And so it should work. No, yes, no, yes, no. No. Right. Damn it. How do I do this? Okay, give me a minute. I have to be 100% certain how to do this successfully, because there are things where we're gonna have to set, you know, a... Oh shit, yeah, I forget. I'm an idiot. Yeah, and then... Yeah, okay. Okay, see, I was almost right with this. I was almost right. Wait, actually, can I do this? Because it should just be a case of doing this. And then... No. No, sir. We cannot do that for now. Please? Please. Please, sir. May I have some more randoms? No? Okay, well, we're going to be creating it up here then. So it'll be spawn point generator. That's actually... Okay, so... and... Damn me, fuck, shit. Okay, so actually, this random up here... I mean, this fucking software, right? Okay, so... might as well create a whole separate area just for the randoms. And it'll be a new random.
What? Why? Why would you do that? Why? Like, literally.
Literally, why? Okay, and what we can do now is, with our newfound power of randoms, we can go in here, and that would almost be correct. So we would have to, you know, declare an int of that name and be like, new random. Oh, shite. Okay, well, I don't know if this will work. Will it work? It won't. I can tell you that much. Oh, okay, it's not new. Still not right, though, because these two are literally the same name. So, yeah. Oh, wait, okay. Wow. Seriously? Like what? You what, mate? You wanna go? Huh? You wanna go, mate? I'll fucking go, mate. Okay, I will fucking go, mate. Yeah, okay. So what we'll do is we'll call this random. So we'll, with this, should be able to do this. I mean, we should be able to. Thank you. Jesus. Fuck me. Like, that was like way harder than it needed to. Okay. Yeah. I think this is good. So what this will determine is the, ooh, and I want to say X position, and I think that will be right, of the spawn point. So like that. And then we have the spawn point set. Okay, so the int spawn point will literally be the random, but we'll need one for the Y axis as well, and it will only, it'll go from 0 to 77. Will this work? Because we're, yeah, seems so. Seems that way. Great. Okay. So, with that in mind, now we have the X and Y coordinates of our spawn point. We will then need... Oh, shite. I mean, we should actually just be able to use this, like, over and over and over and over and over and over. I mean, as far as I can tell, we should literally just be able to do this and just use it again and again, and then eventually, you know, again. Okay, so we will create a new int called spawn point height. Yeah. And this will, again, this will be the same to this, but, and this is the good one, it'll go from 5 to 8. Okay. So the, wait, what will this actually give us? Because we can make it right now. Because I want to, actually, I'd love to know. Okay, so we can just, you know, do one of these bad boys and go like spawn point height. And then that, and then see what it actually get. Okay, so if we do a, whoop, this gives us, oh, interesting, okay. So it gives us up to and not including 8. Huh. Well, very well. Okay, so that can be removed, thank God. That was an awful thing to look at. That was like the Matrix wannabe, but, you know, in spawn heights. So with that in mind, it will only create that once, and then when that is set, we should be able to... Should we create like a random for its width as well? I think we should. Let's do that. So here, it will literally be width, and it will go from, I think it should be like from 7, it should actually be more than that, it should be like, no, it should be 7, I think, to a, that's not right, it should be going to 10, and then including, or not including actually the 10. Okay. Oh, by the way, if anyone has anything to add, please let me know if I'm, you know, totally mistaken and doing everything like a complete moron. I'll be more than open to suggestions. So now that that is said, we are ready to begin. So what we will do is we'll have to create a for loop. So we'll create a new one called... X, yeah, it'll be equal to zero. X has to be, oh god, less than or equal to the spawn point width, I think, width, yeah. And then we'll go like X plus. Okay, yeah, and then we'll, okay, let's just copy this, no reason to do too much work, am I right? So there you go, and it'll be Y and Y and Y. Okay, so with this we'll be, you know, going through and counting upwards to when we can, okay, I have to find a good way to explain this. What we will be doing is we'll be drawing a room, you know, with these kind of floors right there, and then the height will be drawn like that. But we'll have to make sure that it only draws the... Actually, this might be a bad composition or a bad... I should do it in reverse, shouldn't I? Yeah, I probably should. Okay. No problem. Because then... Okay, let me just do this. Let me just focus, because I have a tendency to forget. So, when... So we will go through and it'll be like 0 and then 0. And it will put in spot 0, 0. It will put the this, because that is what it will be. In spot 0, 0, that's the floor, or the very left corner of the floor of the spawn room, and it'll make sure that we are still not at the maximum of the width, which is being generated by the random generator, and then we'll go through, and until we hit that width that is set by the random generator, it will keep drawing the floor, and when we do, it will stop, and then we'll go up and add one to the height, and then we have to make sure that if we are above, if the height is equal to more than 0, that it'll only draw the X position once, which means they will only draw a one layer of wall, otherwise it would draw it like the entire width as well, and it'll fill out and look absolutely horrible, and that's not what we want. So we will have to check it. So okay, so if, can I use it in here? So if y equals 0, or y equals, oh shit. Oh, wait, what? This should be height, shouldn't it? Yeah, okay, so there you go. Did I not spell that correctly? Oh, okay, caps, yeah, sure. Fucking caps. Or if y is equal to spawn point height. God, am I doing this right? I fucking hope so. If that is the case, then it'll draw. Otherwise, it literally won't draw it. No, wait a minute. Oh, God.
Oh God. Okay. So, oh shit. Sorry. So if our looped Y position, which will be our, height position, is 0, as in if we're at the floor, or we're at the top, it will ride out the floor. If not, then it'll ride out one layer of wall. I think so. Good. Okay. Oh, Jesus Christ. So this will be the one layer of wall that'll be drawn right here. Maybe we should do that and then do the other. So if we have a position that is not 0 and not the top either, then what it'll do, yeah, what it will do, god damn it, actually it should be, shouldn't it, like -1. Yeah, I think it should be -1. Because we want there to be a flat surface and not, you know, two spikes and then a flat surface in between. We want it to be just a flat surface on top and on the bottom, and then the walls and the sides to fill out the rest. If we're not at the top and not at the bottom, then what we will do is we will ride out. But only if our X position is equal to 0, or it is equal to the width. Okay, so if this is the case, then we'll draw the wall. Otherwise, no fucking wall. No wall, mate. You what? You what? You want to draw, mate? You want to fucking draw, mate? Okay, so it will set it to... Oh, Jesus. It's x dot y. And then it will write a letter in there. And that will be this. Okay. Okay, so comment. Hey, bro, what language do you know? Well, I do... okay, so I know a couple. There are a few of those that I know very well. I am a certified PHP, HTML, and CSS user. I'm actually not certified at all. I've made a couple of websites, pretty decent ones, working with CSS, HTML5, and PHP for server and database management. I then also, because of my work with websites, have a decent, somewhat understanding of jQuery, which is used for like animation. But I've got to be honest, I couldn't write a jQuery script if I wanted to. I can edit one though, and I can make it fit whatever I wanted it to do. Can't fucking edit one for the life of me. So I also then have a pretty decent understanding of C#, which is, is there any other? Like, I think that's pretty much it. Like Java, I have read a couple of scripts, nothing too... I mean, I've heard that it's very close to what I'm doing, to C#, so it shouldn't be, you know, too much of a problem for me to dive into that, but I'm not too familiar with it. Okay, so back to this. If we're at the width point, which would be like... you know, the end of it, it will draw a wall, or if we're at the start of it, it will draw the wall and nothing in between. So that's good. And if we're at the bottom and otherwise at the top, -1? No, it shouldn't be -1. I'm an idiot. Okay. Then we will draw as well. Then we'll put something in here, and for this we will put the underscore.
Well, it's I've actually been looking for a job lately, I must admit. And I applied for a job, which is, you know, for me, actually, that's very strange. Even my parents were like, "You what? You literally did that? Oh my God." But I did, and I sent that resume. I was like, "Yeah, you know what? I can like do website shit. I can whatever." I was like, "I have a basic understanding of pretty much any language that you'd run into with like an average use, and otherwise, I'll be able to learn it." So, but that's great. It's I mean, it's great to know a couple of languages when it comes to programming. That's always a freaking bonus. I think once we've put something in there, we'll need to print the room, as in like draw it. Oh, did you notice that? Like fucking Java shit. Okay. So we'll need to do like an X draw, which should be equal to 0. So we'll start at the bottom. I think this will actually be at the top. I'm not too sure. And wait. Oh damn. I might actually have done something wrong here. Shoot. Okay, so spawn point height. That should actually be at the bottom. As far as I've seen, it has only generated the room at the. Oh well, I guess it just puts it anywhere. Yeah, it's me. I'm an idiot. Yeah, I'm an idiot. I am literally an idiot. Wait. Hold up. What? What am I doing? So, God. Okay, let's try and write it out and see what happens, 'cause I am not sure anymore. Okay, so as long as I mean, this will be an adventure, really, because I am not sure what is happening. I was pointing again. I'm fucking used to. Okay, so I was not sure what's happening here. I'm not sure and I'm even, you know, remotely heading in the right direction. So the X draw, as long as that's less than or, yeah, less than or equal. God, you know, I've had it. Oh shit, I don't know what they're called. Like blisters, isn't it? On my heel from walking? Like, fuck me, it hurts. Oh no, I'm a big old pussy. Like, I'm a whining piece of shit, am I not? Okay. Did I? I might actually not be going right to the edge of the screen. I think I'm like missing 10 or something. Actually, I might be. So it'll be up to and not including 240. So again, it'll be 39 here. See, that's a bit confusing, isn't it? The way they do this shit. I mean, that's just weird. That shit is weird. Okay, so with that, bam, and then we'll copy and paste whatever this will do. So sounds like it's not even my code. I literally just wrote it. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing though. I mean, I've got to be honest with you. I do not know. So and then it'll have to write like this. So we'll be like, console, please write this fucking shit. Do we even have to do it like this? I guess we can. Might as well. Why not? Okay, so in here. We'll put whatever is in there. So, you know, the Y. Oh shit, it's actually not. It's the X draw. And then the Y draw. Okay. I mean, this will be exciting. I don't know what will happen. Okay, let's see. It's beautiful. That was, that's some. That's, I mean, that. I was touched. I mean, I must admit, I was touched. In places I never thought I'd be touched. Oh. Wow. See, that's a bit of an oversight. okay, let's try that again, shall we? It's fucking what? Okay, fucking what? Okay, out of range. Nice.
Nice.
Shite. Do I start crying now or like in 10 minutes? Or what? Shit. X draw dot Y draw. And it will go from 0. Wait, can I see? Oh, it stopped at 77.
Oh, right.
Maybe that's the issue. Okay, let's try again. It's beautiful. it's everything I ever dreamed of. How come? I mean, it should be like a what are these called when you oh, I don't even remember. I ruined my own joke. I'm an idiot. You know, the flashing light thing where they're like, oh, don't view this if you're an idiot and don't know that you'll die from this. This is absolutely beautiful. Really, it's beautiful. Okay, so you know what? Can I just... Can we save this? Please? I don't want it to... See. See. This. So, I mean... okay. But... like... What?
Oh my god.
Okay. Okay. There seems to be an issue with the way that we draw points, or not points, I mean the spawn. And I think I know what it is, I'm just not sure how to fix it. So we're given a default oh wait, I think for safety we did this, yeah. So we are, you know, we're okay, so we, let me just do it. I think this is what needs to happen. Like that. And then again this, and then plus however far we got on the Y. Because then, and this is my hope, it'll work. Literally did the same. I've never felt so proud. Oh my god. Hello. Okay, so like what? Like you what, mate? Oh my god, I'm awful at this. I am literally the worst. I'm actually worse than Hitler, like right now, worse than Hitler. Okay. So we, okay. Let me just focus for a minute.
Let me focus, everyone, for a minute, please.
Okay. So spawn point height. Yeah, that's the spawn point at Y position. And we're setting it to a default of 0. And we're checking if it is less than or equal to the max that we set it to, which would be generated by a random. And then we're adding 1 for every time we loop through. Then we are looping through and doing the same with a width position. And then we're checking if our Y position is 0. Or if our Y position is at the top. I mean, yeah, but like, no. I don't know. Okay, let me just refresh this. Something happened. Okay, here we go. Well, that's not good. and then... Like, that's when we will draw the floor of the room, which would be at spawn point generator X position. Okay, let's try and run the game for one. Okay, and then we can check the values, can't we? Can I not? Used to be able to. Like, where we're setting it. E and Y. Don't give me this bullshit. Come on. Like, I can literally see it right here. Okay. Don't mess with me. Whatever this Microsoft Visual Studio. I will hunt you down, mate. Literally. I will hunt you down. Okay. I will break you, software. Holy shit. There are a lot of little things here. I mean, I suppose it's because it's not broken, then we can't trace it. Oh wait, actually we can start it. Oh god, that's not what I wanted to do at all. I wanted to start, what? Debug? Can I start the debug mode? Yes. Sheet. Look at that. That literally did nothing. Okay, locals. Locals? Please, no. None. Okay, we have no variables, guys. No variables were found. Absolutely zero. Well, that's great. That means we are screwed. Well, thank you for watching. We're fucked. Okay. Oh my god. Fuck me. You know, I don't know. Oh. Will this change anything? Ooh. No, it will break everything is what it will do. So, I mean, that's great. What the fuck? Can we try that again? No? What? I'm sorry, what? You what? What? Well, this was fun. Thank you for this. I do appreciate that. So what is happening here? I don't know. Okay. Spawn point height. If it's less than or equal. I mean, yeah, but okay. So in our two-dimensional array, which is a string array, I mean, we have put the things in there. It's just that the Y positions don't really seem to, like, Oh, maybe it's this, actually. Give me a minute. Let's try and do this. Can we do that? Well, yeah, we can, but it's fucked. Well, that's fucked. Okay. Maybe it's the way we're drawing it. Oh, yeah, it is. Fuck me. Okay. Well, it literally was that. The way we were drawing it. Okay, so let's... This shit. I mean, the. I'm sorry. What? What? How is that even possible? Okay. Well. Well then.
We have come to crossroads in our life, have we not?
I mean, it should work. It should work, shouldn't it? I mean, there's nothing here saying or doing anything that would make it, you know, not work. It's literally just a case of it being very difficult with me. So the for loop, if and else's and ifs. And for a loop, and it's then waiting for my response. But it seems to be writing it out in a fashion in which I am not very... Oh, you know what? Okay, let's go. Let's do this for glory and for sponsor as well. I mean, why wouldn't you? Like, come on. So we are at the X draw. Thank you for correcting me, game software thing. Oh fuck. Well, okay. Oh, we're literally going too fast and too furious. Are we not? X draw, Y draw. So what? Is that the limit here? 120? And then that would be 119 if I was able to math. Okay, let's try that again. See, no, yeah. No, yeah. Yeah, no. Shit. What? What? Oh my god. What the fuck, like? Can I just, like, can we? Could I please, dearest software that I have? We fucking got it. Look at that shit. That shit's a fucking roommate. You what? It's fucking glorious. Okay, let's try this again. See, it scrolls down like way far. I suppose that would be because of the... Okay, so we'll have to... I think it'd be like 40 then. And not including that. 239. Yeah, so it'd be like 39. Maybe. Who knows? Who knows at this point? Like, this is fucking insane. Like, once we get this going, nothing is gonna stop me then. Like, nothing. What? Oh. So again, 119 and 119. Maybe this will be good. No? No! Nope, 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 no. Yeah, this is something that I figured would happen. Just not good. It's that we have landed on... Yeah, there you go. So we landed on the X position of 111 and our max is 119, and then it would propose that it would be 9 wide. So that's a problem that we are going to have to figure out. So let's see. So when we draw it, let's see. So we'll have to set up a new if. So if our spawn X position plus our spawn point width is greater than or equal to 119, and then we might as well also do it with the Y. So if, and we can just like copy this. I fucking love copying, it's the greatest. Thank God DRAM. Okay, so that and height, and if the height is like, and if this together is like greater than or equal to 39, we will have to do some shit. Okay, so let's say that this is true, that the spawn point generator, the X position for that, plus the width is greater than or equal to, we will have to find the difference in that and then subtract. So we will say, we'll create a new int x should we, yeah, I think we can't do this for both, can we? No, this is not going to be good. So we should just copy this and go back on our promises like a good politician. And here we go. Okay, so we can create like two. Shit, that's not what I was supposed to do. This. So if that's the case, then, and it probably is. It will probably be at one point. Damn. Okay, well, this would be the Y. And this would be the height. And if that would be more than or equal to 39, we will have to do same as whatever we're doing to this one. So we're going to be finding the X difference. This will be equal to, well, I suppose this. Minus 119. So we know, I mean, if it ever gets to this point, we know that the it is greater than 119, so we can subtract 119. I suppose actually we should subtract 120. So that if it is just at the border, that it will go one step back. Because then we will say that this will be equal to, I know some people are gonna disagree with me on this, with the way I do this, but this is the way I'm very comfortable with. Okay, so. So then we'll subtract the difference from the spawn point generator. So it will be safe and secure when we're going to draw it. And we will do the same for this. Although we're looking for some different things here. So we'll say the Y first of all, and the spawn height. And if... so that was 39, so we're going to subtract 40, and then this would be equal to the generator on the Y minus the Y difference. Great. Okay. So at this point, we have found out that we are not at the borders, and if we are, okay. Oh. Sorry. Excuse me. What happened? We're at 0 and 119. Okay. Can we only go to 118 then?
What now?
Like, literally, what now? 105. Plus... Well, that is 105. 33. And why is this an issue? I mean, if the limit, the max limit for the Y position is 39, then why is 33 an issue? Point width is 9. Oh. Okay. Okay, I see. No, I don't actually. Why is 6? It's like 39. Oh, okay. Okay. So we... Shit. What do? Let's see. So we're at... We have 40... usable slots, yeah, and we're trying to put one into the 39th, but that does not exist, does it? It's like it's 39. Yeah, it'd be like putting something into the 120th. No, actually, it'd be like putting something into the 119th, which we can't do either. So why is it doing that? It should have gone through. Okay, it's here. It's right there. So, according to the rules, should be 138, actually. And then, yeah, we'll be making the same mistake down here. Great. Wow, okay, that actually worked. Great. Oh my god, I can't believe it. Only generated a new one. And, like, it screwed up, but it generated a new one. this is awesome. And then it failed. That's not as awesome. Because we're again at 39. Maybe if we do this, like, it'll maybe work every time. Yeah, right. That's the biggest fucking lie any programmer has ever said to himself. Maybe if we do this, it'll work every time. Yeah, fuck no. It fucking won't, and you know it. Lying, man. Okay, so, when the map has been drawn, I think we should draw the stats as well. So we'll be like, console, please set cursor position at... how do we do it last time? There was like a... Oh, God. Okay, well, we know two positions we can do. We can do x118 and then y. We can go all the way to 39. We should be able to. And it'll be like, oh shit. Okay, so console dot right. And we will be writing out in here. Maybe we can actually just do it in, could we? Oh wait, actually no, oh god, shouldn't be doing that, we should be doing this. And we will put in there the, so it'll be like out of and insert. So it'll be char HP current dot char HP full. It'll be like There you go. Let's see where that is put. Oh, nice. Okay. Well, that is good. We might not want it all caps. That looks kind of ridiculous. I thought it would look cool. It does not. Okay. Well, I like this. I like how it... See, that's when I speak too soon. Because we are not dealing with 40 on the Y. We're not dealing with 40. Like, I can tell you that much. So, no, we're actually not. Maybe even... Shit. We might actually... Okay, we can test it here, how much we have to deal with. Or how far we can go. 36.39 again. I mean, it should know this, shouldn't it? It's oh, wait a minute. Okay. Well, this might be like a new trap that I've just set for myself. Where whenever we like generate, give me a moment, I'm just reloading my page over here. I look very shocked. That's kind of nice. So the Y that's generated right here, that was at 3 when it failed because we generated a 36. And that equals out to 39, which again, can't do. But I thought it was, I thought this would be rather secure. I suppose it'll have to be 38 then, maybe. And we should be good to go every time. Okay, so it appears that we have even less than this. So let's go to 25 and see how, so that would be like, so it's 28 or something. Can we just please? Okay, it appears we have 29. Or actually rather that would be 30. 30 on shit, I mean my Twitch right now, it's just horrible. Horrible, horrible, horrible. Let me just try again. I don't know what's going on. Okay. So we should put this down to 29. That'll give us 30 good spots. And we'll have to test if it is 28. And maybe not subtract that much, but we will subtract 29, and then the Y again would be 28, yes, and then this will be 29. Okay, well, immediately got problems, because that equaled to... Oh, you know what? Maybe we should, okay, maybe we should generate the height and the width after after we have generated the height and the width, or we should generate the x and the y positions after the height and the width, because that way we can subtract from the full number what number we generated. I think that would be good. Okay, maybe we should try that. So we can literally just move it up and then move that down. So the x would be equal to 119 minus the spawn point width, and then this would be equal to that minus the spawn point height. Let's see if this will work, because then, like, we should get solid. No, still problems. Minus one. Minus one. But then we might run into a whole other problem. Okay, let's test it for a while. Okay, there you go. Noise. Okay, it appears we are... And I will watch out when saying this, because you never fucking know, but it appears we're almost good to go. Seems like it, yeah. Okay. Well, that was great. Okay. Wow, that actually went pretty damn well. I had not expected that. Not at all. Okay. Wow. Yeah. We should probably also write out the score. And that should be done at a... Let's say 80. And it'll be like, score. And there'll only be one. And that would be the... Let's see if I... what did I call it? What did I even call it? Did I not make one? Oh, I just called it score. GG. GG. Okay, that way. And then, no, we'll draw that right there, and that's good. Or maybe we should keep it tight. Should we keep, actually, yeah, we might want to do that. Okay, so this is gonna be like, let's say 20. Might still be way too... Oh, it's actually pretty good. That looks fine. Okay. Great. Oh, shit, my hair. God damn. Okay, so... let me just do this, because this is ridiculous. Like, I don't know what's happening right now. Everything has just gone to shit. Can I... do this? Oh great. Okay. Yeah, here we go. So now we can just, you know, keep going, and it will generate a room, the first room at least, successfully every single fucking time. There you go, that's great. And it's even a different room. Like that, I love that more than anything. It will be a different experience every time this way. Okay, so now, I mean, this will be drawn, I guess we should actually remove it from here, because it will only be confusing, but we'll do it after the console clear. So we'll literally do this right at the beginning. We'll draw out that, so it will be the first thing to be drawn, and then... Oh, I copied the read line as well. Oh, that would be great. No. Oh my god. Welcome to the maze game. The game in which you must find your way through this maze. It might be impossible, it might not be. Who knows? God. It's great. Okay, actually, no, we will not do that. What we will do is we will... will I ruin everything? Yes, I will ruin everything by doing that. Great. Great.
Oh my god. Great. How do I go back now? I want to open my project and solutions. Okay, here we go. I just wanted to copy something from the text-based RPG that we did. Should I? Yeah, I mean, might as well. But not the space bar. Okay, actually, this is fucking copy it. And we'll sort it out when we get to it. So player controls everything from that. And then, you know, open, project and solutions, rogue. There you go, great. No. Well, great. Thank you for that. Can I not? Please? Rogue, will you open? Well, I'm fucked. I will never find my way back again. I'm lost. Here we go. There you go. Great. So down here, after all this is done, I know we'll have a huge fucking mess of shit right there. We can delete all that. And then we can also delete this. And we can do one of these. There you go. So we have, oh god, up, down, less or greater than, suppose, zero. Yeah, that should be fine. Move left and right greater than, yeah, I suppose one. And 118, yeah, that should be fine. And 27. I suppose so, yeah. Nope. No. I suppose we will need these. Kind of an oversight. How was I gonna know? Okay, so by default they will be zero, and we'll also have, okay, and we'll also have this, which will also be zero. And let us test that. So can I, this is incredible. This is literally the maze game. I love it. Oh god, I love it when things do not work, like, at all. Well, I suppose they're, or the characters, well, we can't really do this, can we? We'll have to spawn him in like this, and then his left and right position will be his X position will be this plus one, and then his Y position would be this again plus one. Okay, can we go? Fuck no, we can't. We have no choice. We're stuck. Okay, no, it's just this. Okay, there we go. Okay. Well, that was incredible. Sure was. Gee willies. I mean, fuck me. Like, I suppose this would have to go up here then for it to work. Oh, but then it'll only draw it whenever this is fucking true. This is ridiculous. Okay, then no. Maybe not. I mean, it's a free country. I'm not gonna try and ruin its day or anything, but, like,
really prefer it. I really would. Okay. So you can tell where it, oh God, this looks awesome. So the problem is that it keeps generating rooms, which, you know, kind of the point of the game, but yeah. Okay, so maybe we'll create a new one called room counter, because there will be other rooms created if and then we should create one called rooms counted. So if room counter is equal to, no, it's not equal to room counter, then it will create a room. Shit. Okay, come on. And it will do it till here. Yep. So it will create a room then. So if rooms counted, and that will be by default be zero. So if that is not equal to room counter, it will do it, and if it is, it will be next turn, and it will do that. Okay, let's see. Did not work. Why? I don't fucking know. Oh wait, I forgot. God, I'm a genius. So rooms counted plus plus. Okay, there you go. So now, I mean, aside from flying around, okay. See, this would be the problem then. That because of its nature. You know what? There's actually something that we can do. It'll be kind of difficult, but we can do it. So we will set we will take this and we will use it. So we'll say that draw game map will be char move up down, no, left right, and then char move up down be equal to, and then we'll insert the player, and then we will go one back. Should, that is going to be an issue. Then we'll go back one as described here, like that, and set that to, I guess, null. What now? What now? This! So it works here, but it doesn't work there. Oh, because I don't have that. Okay, great. Thank you. Thank you for that. I mean, that feels great. Okay. So when we move, it'll put us into the array. Apparently by fucking default or random or whatever. Okay, but whatever. Oh, I suppose this is an error. Shouldn't be in. That actually made a lot more sense than I thought it would. So putting that in there, it'll be left, right. So if we move left, we will move. Wait, what? Oh yeah, so we'll have to do a plus here. Oh, that's not a plus, that's a plus. And okay, I thought we were gonna have trouble, but we weren't. And so if we go one down, we'll have to reset the upper one by one. And then if we go, this way, like if we go up, I suppose that would be right. Okay, let's try it. Damn it. Okay, why? Let's see. Try and move left, right, up, down. Oh. Okay, well, that is not needed. Like, at all. I don't think it will be. I think that was stupid. And now we got trouble. Oh my god. But then we... my god, fuck me. This should only be generated... Like, this whole thing should only be generated once. You only generate once. And, like, in here, I suppose we can put it like that in... Right at this very start, and then this will have an issue because it hasn't created those yet. So we will go back. And oh shit! I suppose right here. No, wait, why not? It's because we're. Oh my god! Oh my god, I have never had so much trouble with something this simple. Literally never. Never fucking ever. Okay, But see, we will need to put Well, that's kind of interesting. Like, we'll have to put this in, obviously. Like, this is an important factor for where the character will be spawned. Like, right in the corner of the spawn room. The problem then seems to be that whenever we do this, it goes back. It goes back and it regenerates this. And by that, I mean it generates these random spawn points, like over and over and over and over. I suppose we can actually... You know what? Okay, you know what? We're going to do one of these. Okay, we're going to do one of these bad boys. So up here, we'll create it and we will put it to zero. So we'll start out at like a default position. Then, and this is where this is removed, we will go here and we'll insert it right there. And then it should only be... Oh, okay, we shouldn't have to do this. But it should only be done once. Here we fucking go, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, I can like delete the entire thing. but I mean, that's a whole other thing, isn't it? Okay. There you fucking go. I just ate the entire room. And also, I am apparently... Oh, shit. Okay, don't. Kids, don't keep the arrow keys stuck in there. It's not good. So, apparently, I am able to move where fucking ever. So, we should set up some... a few premises for this. So, if... Oh, we're trying to move left and right. So, we will bump into... the straight lines. So if our char move left right plus one equals, no, that's not what we want to check. We want to check if this and then left right plus one, yeah, equals a one of these. It is not allowed to move. Else, we should be allowed to move. How nice is this? Look at this shit. So literally just copy and paste for everything. Okay. And then, you know, a... Oh. There you go. It should be then minus one. And then up, down, we will bump into some other thingies here. So those would be an underscore. And then obviously we shouldn't check that. But when we're moving up, we're going... Let me just launch this. What it? Okay. Okay. The up arrow will apparently add one. I suppose. I mean, to me, it didn't make sense, but now I see. Yeah, okay. It makes sense. I could understand if I had some trouble with that one. That was a bit trickster like. Okay, so this did not work. Although, you know, I can't go that way. I can obviously go this way. Can't go this way, and can't go that way. But I can. I can eat my way up. And if that is not, you know, consumerism and imperialism at its best, then I don't know. And also, I'm fucking stuck. So apparently I have to switch this around. So it'll be minus one and... Oh, okay. I suppose that would be sufficient. No. Okay, no. No. That way. Let's see. I cannot even spawn. Okay, great. Alright, great. Fucking great. So now I can't... Oh my god, I mean, I can bug the game out to shoot. But like, I can't exit this room, even if I wanted to. So that's great. Now that that is done... well, we... You know, there will be some roads generated. And those you will be able to walk on... but if, oh, actually, it should be like, or this whole thing equals null. So like if there's an empty space, you can't walk on it. If it's a the top of a something or the bottom of a something, then you can't walk on it, which, you know, should make a lot of sense. Okay, let's see. How do I spawn? I fucking can't, because I'm an idiot. Okay, so actually it shouldn't be. I was wrong. What it should be, it can be null, because if it's not, then you're not, well, okay, you know what we'll do, so we will redo. Okay, can't do that. Literally can't do that. So we'll redo it, and then in shit. Okay, this is gonna be difficult. So we will fill all rooms with dots, and then you'll be able to move around inside the room. So we won't be allowed to move on the empty spaces on everything that ain't the road. Okay, so if we're at the top and bottom, it will do this. So it's here. So, and else we will do this and just insert a dirt. Bam. Boom. Okay, how does this? Fuck me. What's the problem? What seems to be the problem here, officer? No problem. Oh, okay. Well, I understand, officer. Okay, everything is fine. Nice. And then we won't be able to backtrace. Okay, so instead of setting it to null, be setting it to a dot. That's kind of like a little smiley face. Little smiley face. Okay, here we go. There you go. Start it. So now it'll reset everything. Oh, this is nice. It's like a multiple floor house, isn't it? Like the dots are little floors, and then, you know, you go and visit Mrs. Robinson on, you know, the top floor, the one with the laced bra and all, and you'll go bang her for multiple hours, and you won't really tire, will you? Okay. With that done, I think we should get to generating roads. Yeah. But then, oh God. Okay, well, there's a whole other thing we need to. Well, I suppose we can just copy and paste this, because if we're going to be creating roads, which we are, and they will lead to another house, which they will, there would be an issue with creating the new rooms, because the new rooms would literally be created at random. And that's not what we want. If we create the new rooms at random, they won't be adjoined by the roads, which would be bad. It would be way bad. So let's start out. So how did I even create a random to begin with? Random. Here we go. So we can take one of these and we just call them whatever. So we will go for a, yeah, I suppose it will have to. Okay, so this will be spawn first road. Okay, so it will be
it, oh god, I guess okay, give me a minute. This will be a bit fucking weird. We'll have these. So if let's only look at the that's not a no, we'll have to look at both X and Y. So X. So spawn point generator X position is less than or equal to 49, which would be at like the halfway point. No way, I guess it's 120, so it'll literally be like 59. Okay, that's good. So if we are looking, okay, what is happening here? Everything's broken. So if the X position, if we're like at less than halfway, it will go right. So we'll generate on the right. And if, does this even matter for the generating? I guess it does, yeah. So if the spawn point generator landed at an X position that is less than or equal to 59, it will make the road on the right. So then it will have how do we do this? So it will take and it will create a random, but based on the, that would be the height then. So based on the height that is generated, so spawn point height. So that would be the, I guess it would be 0 point spawn point height. And again, issues. Okay. So spawn point height does not exist in this context, which is a bit of a problem. I guess these don't have to be in there. Actually, they kind of do. Okay. But then again, I guess this could also be in there. This doesn't have to be outside of the room generation or generating. So in here, we'll put the first road. So we know what's going on. And then we can use spawn point height. So we'll create a new one based on the spawn point height. And I guess it'll be -1 and also it'll be from 1. So it has already chosen. And then at that point, whatever this landed on will be put into this. And it will draw it as a hashtag. That's cool. It's kind of road-ish. So whatever the
So what we are looking at, see if we so we're looking at like spawn point generator, whatever it landed on the X. If that's above 59, or actually less than 59, so if we're in the left half of this screen, you'll have to create it on the right, and then we're looking to create it on the height and not on the axis, because if we're creating on the axis, it will create on the top and the bottom, which won't be important right now. Oh god. And then we'll also have to have a roll, which will be between 1 and 2, really. It'll be a 50-50 on if it'll create it on the top or if it'll create it on the bottom. And both will be counted on, like, where are we on the screen? Like, if we want to go down, or we want to go up or left or right with the road. So at the spawn point, plus X, and we don't want to add Y. So we want to keep it... No, actually, we want to keep the X axis plus 1, and then the Y axis. Wait, this will be, oh god. So this will be spawn point generated Y position. It'll be counting. I don't even know, actually. I don't know. Let's see. Oh, really? Really? Oh, it just does the same. Okay. I was really impressed. I was like way impressed. I was like, wow. Damn, like that's some cool shit. But then again, I was fairly disappointed very quickly. So it was like just one. So I guess the Y position, yeah, it's like from the top. And do we want to, oh god, like what am I even looking at right now? Oh shit, I shouldn't have done that. Oh shit, I shouldn't have done that either. Can I just move it? Okay, so it will, the Y position, I guess not, but we will want to add, because we're looking to create it on the sides, aren't we? So we should add the width and then plus 1. Oh god, stop it. Spawn point width and then plus 1, and then we'll end up like on the corner, aren't we? It's just gone. It's fucking gone. It's like, nope. I won't be victim to your abuse, Sebastian. It's like, no, come back. I robbed you. Okay. And then at all times the Y plus 1, but also plus the one that we just generated, which actually won't be an X value at all. It'll be a Y value. So plus this, and then plus 1. Well, look at that. Will you have a look at that? It generated it all by itself, and none this time. So no roads. We're getting no roads. Oh, I suppose it's because it, yeah, okay, it actually figured it out pretty quickly. And we are still not in the right position, still not. There we go. Okay, so it actually figures it out pretty quickly. That's great. So to be able to walk on these, we shouldn't add one. Nope. Because then we'll be creating it like, oh god, this is going to be annoying. Well, it's good to know it actually works. So we could be able to walk on it now, can't we? Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It will then replace the road that we've just walked on with dots, which is not too good. Okay, it's a problem for another time. It's a very first world problem right now. So I suppose we'll have to do the inverse. So if it's greater than or equal to 59, this was less than. So actually it should just be greater than, because then if it hits 59, it will do this, and if it's 61, it will do this. So that's probably good. let's see. We will have to do it on the left. So, well, as opposed to this, we literally just need a minus one. And then keeping everything the same probably work. Okay, actually, no, it wouldn't. It would have to be minus two for it to work. And then it will work every time. Fucking no, it doesn't. No, of course it doesn't. No, I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. I'm an idiot. Okay, and then we should do the same with this, actually. But for... Damn it. What the fuck just happened? Okay. But for the Y. So if that is less than or equal... And how tall was it again? It was 30? Yeah, 30. So if it is less than or equal to 15, I suppose 15. 15 will be good. Yeah, then it will create it on the bottom. So let's see. We will be... I suppose then this would apply over here. Let's see how that works. Yeah. Did it work? Can I? Yeah, it did. It's kind of cool. But then I'm also able to just, you know, run and hide if I wanted to. Well, that's another flaw in the game, but still, it works. It works. Oh, shit. Okay. Oh, fuck, what? You what, mate? You fucking what? Okay, we're still... I don't know. See, it should be at like... You see, there's something wrong here. See, when it goes below that, that's when it actually should do this. So it's reverse. It's like that. And then we should create one that's actually for this. So less than or equal to 15, and then it'll... I can't do this. Let's see. So now it creates one that's on the top, and then it creates one that's on the top. Great. So on the Y, we need to add the spawn point height, and then we should I mean, the exposition. Well, that should be. Yeah. Wait, what? Okay, so for these, actually, it should be that the max would be the width minus one. Then we should see some good shit. And then it created on the bottom. It didn't start. Okay, on the top and on the left, bottom and left, bottom and left, top and right. And it appears to me, seems to be random, yeah. Yeah, sure it does. Oh god, the green names, Jesus. Well, hello. Cakes and cocaine. Oh, classy audience. Fucking love it. Well, hello. Well, we are, right now, we are, we've created the rooms for the rogue game, which are being put into the game by random positioning. And then we are making roads for the player to walk upon, which are also, and this seems to be kind of an issue, but which are also being generated by random. So again, it's pretty good. It works. As you can see, these hashtags, they are the roads, and the player can walk around on those. You can generate the person right here, and we can walk around on these, and we'll create more of these, but like right now, it fucking works. And I'm like super happy about that. How is this even? Okay, so it won't draw if the person is on this or if it's on nothing. So yeah, that's what's happening right now. We should have like a roll between 1 and 2. So in all honesty, it'd be between 1 and 3, but yeah. So we're going for a first road and roll. Fucking row. So if the spawn first roll equals the one, it will go for making a road on the X position, or on, actually, let's see. Okay, so it rolled the 2, it rolled the 1. Yeah, I think so. I don't know what this game is up to. I don't know these rules. I don't know myself. Okay, so if spawn roll equals 2, you'll go for generating this. So let's see. Now it should just generate one of these roads every time, and it'll be at random, based on where we are. So like you can tell we are, okay, so we are at this room here is definitely drawn on the left side of the screen, which will be split like right here or something, and so it will draw the road on the right, and here we're definitely on the right side, and we're close to the bottom, so it drew it on the top. which is pretty great. And then again, it had the choice. You could either draw it on the bottom, or again, this time we're on the left side, so you could draw it on the right. And it choose to draw it on the right. But I think there might be some issues doing this, because sometimes, like this, I think it'll be fine. We will be fine. So now it has created the first road. And then whenever we take a step, it'll redraw the map. Or the game, in this case. But if we step on a on the road, on the first road, it should create or input another step for us to take next time we will take a step. So there will be one put right in front of us, and then it will have to remember this. Like where it started, because that's going to play like a huge fucking role in this. So, I mean, the character will be drawn, and then the move will be taken. So then next time, so here we can actually, right in here, so we, so whilst still putting into and generating the room. Well, actually, I'm not too sure. Because we did put the entire thing in like one of these, in an if. Okay, let's see. Where does it end? Ends right there. Huh. Well, that's interesting for sure. Because I'm pretty sure that that it will create one room and then be like, well, I'm jumped on. Because it has to be different then. So as long as this is zero, the room's counted, which by default will be zero. Because then when it draws a room and makes the first road, it will add to the rooms counted. And this is to prevent that it just draws like 700 rooms. But maybe it shouldn't hold everything back like this. Maybe it should only be to, like right about here, actually, be fine. And then we should do this. Okay, because then, oh damn, what now? Oh shit, I think I broke something now. Oh god damn it. What did I just do? Well that's... Shit. Okay, well this is not good. So it's open and... Oh, Jesus Christ. Okay, so this is... That's that. This is this. And then this should be this, but it's not for... Okay, it is. Great. And then it'll create the first row. Will it still work? No. Oh, because now fuck this. Fuck. Well, it will only do this once, won't it? It will. Yeah, so what we can do
It's like, we can do this. So we can make an int called... wait, what are we even missing here? Missing the spawn point height, width, and generated x. So spawn x equals this, and then int spawn y equals well, it's actually not right here, so cut. Okay, and a y, and int spawn, let's see, w will be that, and then int spawn h equals this then, and Obama the God, yes, I am self-taught. I spoke of that on my previous video. And yeah, I mean, I was doing some education shit, and I was like, well, actually, it's a bullshit story, but so I was doing this education thingy, and it was super fucking legit. Oh, actually, this won't work either. Shit, I'm a fucking idiot. But yeah, I was in school, and we had this course, which was like a 6 or 12 week course. I don't remember, but I think it was 6. And we learned the basics of C sharp, enough to make like a bit of a software and then show it off at the exam, but not more than that. And so, yeah, I learned from that C sharp. It's like the very basics, at least. Yeah. So yeah, I'm self-taught after that. So that was pretty much just the basics, the very basics. Like I'll tell you. and I had to, in order to actually complete that with a good grade in programming, I had to really study on my own. Not that there's anything wrong with that. It's just, you know, it was so basic that, and also it was an interest of mine. I really liked it. So yeah, I am self-taught. Oh yeah, you taught yourself Java. Yeah, well, it's pretty cool. I will admit, it's pretty dope. I would like to know a bit more about Java. You know what? What I do know of Java is what I've basically just come across when browsing the webs. So it's not much, as you can probably imagine. I mean, I do my best. to do not sound a complete idiot when talking of these things, but why is this wrong? Why is everything wrong here? Okay, just so you know, I have literally no clue what I'm doing right now. Literally putting things in and just hoping for the best. And oh god, will this even work? Lowercase x. Yeah, it's lowercase, and well, and so is the y. But where? Huh. Did I? No, it's the same up here. Damn. Why does that not work? Okay. Use of unassigned variable. Well, that's just fucking typical.
Okay. So if I put them to zero, we should be fine then, right? Theory Illuminati confirmed. No. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. There you go. Oh, fuck me. And they're not even symmetrical. And they don't even move right. Like, what? Fucking yeah. Flips keyboard. Oh, jeez, Louise. Fuck me. Okay, let's go back. Let's go way back. Okay, here we go. So this is not a good way of doing it. Let's go back again. Okay, still here. Need help? Well, I wouldn't say no to needing help, but like as it is now, I know what I'm not doing. I'm a fucking pro, mate. I'm a pro. Okay, so one thing I don't get is why I... Oh, wow, okay, that's pretty good. See, sometimes I get stuck like this. And then, like, what? See, I can... Oh, God. Like, what? And then I get stuck. Like, this makes no fucking sense. It's probably somewhere in the... Let's see if I can move to the left. I can't move to the left if there's a dash like that, or if it's empty, which you know made sense. Well, so what's happening? Is that whenever, I mean, this is way too comprehensive to just, you know, being able to do on the stream, but like, you see, when I don't even know how to explain it. That's how difficult this is. Okay, let's just keep going. Keep the show rolling. Keep the dollars floating. Keep, oh God. So when a move is made, so should we, I suppose we would have to wait a fucking minute. The entire map is drawn after all this, and then we take player movement. I suppose it works. Whatever. If it works, it works. All right. Am I right? I know I am. Just asking to be cool. So we will do the road creator software 2.5. Okay. So the road creator. Well, we have an issue. That is, I am pretty sure that I have no way of using any of these variables, like the random numbers that have been generated. You need a dungeon room generator. Well, kind of, actually. But if you're gonna, like, send me one, don't. That's the whole point of this. So, what will happen is the road creator will... It should... but I'm... I'm pretty sure. Okay, so what will happen is we need a road creator to find where the last known location of a road is, which would be every hashtag. But I don't know how we'll find it. So I think what we will need is for it to see the player location and then see if the player is yeah, I mean, it could look at a player location and then look at the content of what the player is about to step on. And then when, you know, one move is left until he steps on it, there will be more road ahead created. I think we could do that, yeah, sure. Okay. But maybe we can even this is horrible. I think if we put this in here, okay, let's try that. Because if we're able to put one of these character move things in here, and no, we can't do that. Okay, let's just check it like this. Oh shit, we can. Really? Fuck. I suggest making the obstacles and stuff first and displaying the base of proximity of the player. Well, what happens, and this is the entire thing walked through, like we create the room, find the walls and all that, make it, fill it with dots, and then insert the player. And then the player moves. Because the player is like being put in afterwards, so he has to move to activate his location. But then when he moves, he's able to move on all the dots and then not on the dashes of any kind. And he's able to move on the hashtags, but then he'll be stuck somehow. So it's not, that's not the issue. So apparently we can use these or all the player character things in here, which is good. It's really good. So we'll have to make the road creator in here. Oh god, that's good. Well, all the text is stored in a two-dimensional array, like right here. And the character is stored in there as well. Him along with everything else is being put into the array, and then every time we go through it, it will loop and it will rewrite the entire array. It's a bit of a shitty way to do it, but it works, and then I don't care. That's like my philosophy. It works and I don't give a shit. So the road creator. If we can, yeah, sure. Advice is welcome. Okay, I'm about to get some advice. I always get this and it's great. Oh shit, hash maps, no idea, mate. So we'll have to find the player's position, like the current position. So maybe we should that would be difficult. Well, we could just find so we'll make like a new int and call it character position on the x equals the character's move left right like that, and then an int called character position on the Y. It will be equal to character move up and down like this. Okay. Yeah. Then. Oh God, I don't even know now. So we have an X and a Y position of the player. So we can test if character position X minus one. No, this is not the right way of doing it, because we will have to test the array. So it will be this. Yeah. So if this player Y. Oh shit, well that went wrong. That went wrong real quick. Okay, there you go. Oh God. Well, I think I'll be fine without using those hash maps, but thank you for letting me know. I appreciate it. Might look into it. Might. Not promising anything. definitely not promising anything. Okay. So if this... So we need to test if that is a hashtag. So this will test if the player has just stepped on one of those last turn, which would be good. It'd be fine. I mean, the render distance on this game will be very minimal at best. I mean, and the worst thing is, like, Total Biscuit is gonna rip me to pieces because there won't be any FOV sliders. But like, we'll have to integrate an FOV slider somehow to please the biscuit. God, oh, that would be kind of funny though, just for biscuit options, which is just like an FOV slider. And it will literally just make the entire window widescreen as fuck. It'd be great. It would be great. So if he has just stepped on one, we will have to go back and look at the roll. Because the roll will tell us where it's gonna go. The next one. And from that, we can gather nothing. Yeah, okay, from... maybe we should have, like, a string that literally says went left, went right, up and down. So we can just go in and say, oh, yeah, okay, it went up or it went down. I think we should do that. Okay, so string, and call the direction equals, in this case, what? it went to the right. Yeah. Right, then we can copy this. I mean, this is an awful way of doing it, but it will work.
and it will tell us exactly where it just went, and then we can like really clarify, like, where the fuck are we?
like where are we?
Well, the array is not gonna go, you know, completely balls. I have it under control somehow. So if it is greater than 15, it went up, and then it went here. It went down, and here it went up. So with that said, we now know. We can, I mean, do we even, no, we don't even need to look then. We can, yeah, so we have, so we have the direction it went, which is going to be good, because that's the direction it's going to follow. Oh, it's, I mean, it's at least going to try. Yeah, so we should, because we're gonna do like a roll for this, which will be 1 through 4, where 1 will be a step down or up, depends on which way it was going, and then 2 and 3 will be left and right, and then 4 will be generate a new room. But the problem with that, it's like pretty self-explanatory. We're gonna have to count how many steps the road has already taken. So we're gonna have to count road steps, which by default is gonna be 1, because we already generated 1. Oh god. Oh, I felt good. Oh god. So if we stepped on a hashtag. Yes. If we stepped on a hashtag, we'll have to create a new one. And then the first thing we're going to do is that the road step, we'll add 1. So we know we're now at 2. And so we'll check if road steps is, greater than or equal to 2, we will allow it to move left and right or create a new room. But if it is not, more than 2, it would just take another step. It'll be like, yeah, we'll just, you know, be patient, do another. And so we will have to look. So if direction, well, this is bad, should have created it up there, so a string called direction, and we can literally just delete this and this, like everything right there till there and there, and now we should be able to do it. So if direction was equal to, let's start with right. It will do a something. Wait, what? Okay, well, I suppose it will need these, but what is wrong here? Use of unassigned local variable. Shouldn't be unassigned though. Well, we just have it blank then, whatever. Because I know it won't be blank for long. So if it's right, it'll do a something, a step. Everything will have to depend on something else. And that's the inherent flaw of this game, and why it'll take a while to make. So the right step, if it has already taken a right step, we should just be able to, and we can take this, actually we can just reuse that. And say that, fine, then
the character exposition plus one will be set to a something. And we'll obviously end that. Only assignment call, increment, decrement, and new object expression can be used. Oh yeah, okay, because I'm using that double. And there you go. Great. I didn't even notice that. And if we go left, then it should be minus one. If we are going up, it should be the Y position, minus one. Shit, he's just going right now. He's just, I mean, he, by he, I mean me, just fucking cracking at it. And plus one. So let's see if this works, because it should. And then we should be able to just walk forever and ever and ever. And I broke the game. Ah, damn it. Oh, okay, yeah. So if we take a step, it will. No, but this is only if we. Oh, that's not gonna work then. This is gonna. Okay, so it's greater than one. Amazing. That's a brilliant way of checking anything. If it's greater than, like, fuck all. fuck me. Like, I don't even. Like, what? Greater than or equal to one? Do we even have to check it at this point? Okay. Plix. No. Okay. Everything's broken. Shit. Oh, okay. Well then. Okay. Let us plux do this then, because that went wrong way fast. Ah, fuck me. Like, still didn't work. I mean, so if a character position, okay, let's test it, see if it actually tracks us. Okay, let's see, anything? Nothing. Can I not? I would actually really like it. Can I not, because I want to know, and it doesn't tell me where I am. Can I see it up here then? Because I must have. No. Shite. Okay, well, this is bad then. You know what we could do? We could, if this even is true, just write true. Like, it doesn't even matter where it writes it, just that it writes it would be great. Never wrote it. Never. Not even once. Okay. Yeah. I don't know why this wouldn't work. 'Cause, like, we. Interesting. Oh, you know what? Oh, damn it. It's because of this, isn't it? It's because of this. Like, if that went there, we wouldn't be able to do this, and then we wouldn't be able to put it in. Oh, fuck me. Okay, so clearly that was not the way to go. Yeah, that went poorly, to say the least. That's why it didn't even work, because it was always zero. Okay. So we'll have to move this. Is it everything in there? Yeah. So everything in there down into the move. I can't be right. Can I do it here? No. The answer is apparently no. Oh god. The worst thing is, it's not even that these are created in here, it's just, like, I don't know. Oh, interesting. Okay. So maybe. Okay. Follow me here. Because I have to do one of these at some point. And. Okay, actually, I have to declare it an int. Oh god, what now? Okay. Oh my god. Like, my fucking head. I'm probably dying here. I'm probably gonna die. Like, most likely, I will die. that's most likely what's gonna happen, actually. So, be aware. Shit. So, so these are not allowed to be used right from the beginning. Yeah, because they're not set and they can't be, because if I set him in here, I guess I kind of have to. Well, they are set in here. Fuck you, game. They are fucking set in here. Like, they're right here. Literally being set at this moment. Okay, so does it have to be 0 by default? Fuck this business. Okay, that actually works then. And that actually breaks the game then. Okay, so we can move, no worries. But creating this down here didn't work. And I am not sure why. Okay. Let's try and where did I set the interface? That's at 29. 80 and 29. So we'll set it at like 129. And then we'll write true if ever. Because if it won't, fucking rage quit right this moment. It should say true, but it doesn't. It doesn't. Well. Let's see. Okay, can I track it here? If I no. No, it appears not. Normally, okay, let's try and can we enter like debug mode? Start debugging. So I'd really love to know where things are. And when entering debug mode, I should be given like something, some sort of an error interface. But no. Okay. Select tools. That's not what I was looking for. Still not what I'm looking for. I mean, I remember a time. An easier time in my life when I was able to call hierarchy. Okay, wait a minute. View, class view. Rogue you. Yeah, no, nope. Okay. Call hierarchy. Still not what we're looking for. An output. Shit. This? No. No, can't use that either. There should be like a no definition. Object browser? No, it's definitely not yet. Jeez. Okay, there you go. Solution. I mean, that's all fine, that, but it doesn't help. Okay, well, I think that'll be enough for today then, and I'll try to figure it out until next time. Well, let me just refresh you for a moment. But thank you all for watching and tuning in whenever you did. I do appreciate it. This was quite the project, I must admit, and it seems to me that I have actually a bit more than I should have, but I hope that you on the videos will be able to tell me maybe what I did wrong. I mean, you always do. So thank you all for watching, I really do appreciate it, and not to worry if you're watching the whole video, there will be going little clips of it up on my channel later. Along with the text-based RPG, we're definitely not done with that. That will come alongside with this, if you don't already know. It's kind of pointless telling you now, actually realizing. Oh god. Thank you all for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I will see you all next time.